And here we are. We are at Solterra and we're going to be doing our winter remedies for those who are here or who are coming, as well as on here on Facebook Live, which is so awesome that we can finally share these type of classes with everybody. And if you miss it, you get to watch the replay. So we are in Florida. And so in Florida, I'm gonna put this so I can look at both of you. And in Florida, we don't have that much of a winter, but I'm already seeing the effects of the colder season on my daughter, who was coughing this morning, and even myself. Just, I can feel the weather shifting. And so it's a good thing when the weather shifts, because we're coming from the hotter months where, you know, maybe things are detoxing easier because we're sweating, and then we start to go in these colder months and we constrict. So all of our blood vessels constrict. And that can look like a cold when really your body is just doing this natural change and detox. So when we expand and contract our blood vessels, it literally pushes toxins through all of our chimneys. So out of our lungs, skin is the biggest way, your intestines, your bladder, so your urine and feces. Do you have anything for him? Okay. So otherwise there's pretzels in the fridge that are gluten-free. Okay, so you know, if you too are seeing some things shift in your body or it comes up in your body, I love to share the remedies we use in our house. So we have this store, which is awesome, but really this business and this outreach really started from us, what we use in our house, and because we care about people so much, we are always sharing with others what we're using. So the first thing is we're going to be talking about some essential oils to help with your typical, you know, bugs that we get, cold and flu type symptoms that start to happen. And, you know, I have to first say I'm not a doctor. I am a health practitioner. I am a wellness advocate, but I'm not a doctor, and I'm not here to say that, you know, this is definite for you. You have to check within your own inner physician. And if you do see an outer physician, you know, you can talk with them as well. But these are not meant to cure. They are meant to allow your body to get in the right balance so it can heal itself. And so one of these, an awesome drink that we could do would be to use lavender, lemon, and peppermint and melaleuca. So melaleuca is also known as tea tree, and this is a cold drink. So if you're feeling the yuckies or you're feeling a bug, you would take 2 drops of melaleuca, 2 drops of peppermint, 2 drops of lemon, and 2 drops of lavender. And you would put all of those in a half a cup of water, and then you would add another half a cup of water, stir it, and drink it. And this will help flush whatever's starting to happen. As far as if you picked up a bug, it'll help to flush the outside of the cells looking for bacteria and the inside of the cells looking for just any sort of, you know, activity that's not for the highest good, and get your body naturally immune system kicked in so that you can push it on out and get back to homeostasis and balance. So I would suggest muscle testing to see if that remedy is for you. Remember, you can do body forward for yeses, this makes me strong. Body backward for no's, that this is not the remedy for me. Maybe it's a certain ingredient. Maybe your body doesn't like melaleuca. I have a girlfriend who's on our team who does not do well with melaleuca. So you always want to check. Even though a remedy might be listed, it just might not be the one for you. But if you did get a yes to this remedy, then what I would also ask your body is say, you know, should I do this again tonight? You know, should I do it 2 times today, 3 times today? It's really an awesome tool to be able to ask yourself these questions. And then just for overall seasonal sensitivities, we even have Tri-Ease capsules of the lemon, lavender, peppermint already mixed up in a little gel cap. That if you are one that's known for seasonal sensitivities, you know, you can do that also pretty regularly, and it's mixed with coconut oil. If you didn't have those gel caps, you could just literally mix these 3 in the drink, like we just said, for the bug drink. Or what I do for Aaliyah is I put them on the soles of her feet. So for our kids, I don't recommend that they drink them. They're a little spicy sometimes. And you don't want to turn them off to them. I've done that with Aaliyah. And we have a little one here today, which is awesome. But with the feet, it's such a great way to apply to our kiddos and to those who maybe don't know what's actually occurring. And what you want to do is, you know, for your smaller kids under 50 pounds, I would say one drop is enough of each. And you can mix it in a little dish, a ceramic glass or steel dish, coconut oil or olive oil if that's all you had. You could use almond oil, sesame oil, jojoba oil is Daniel's favorite. And you can mix it in that dish and you can put it to the soles of your feet so that it gets to your child or to yourself bloodstream in about 30 seconds. And then it goes systemic and actually can go throughout your body where your body decides it wants to go. So I love using the sole of the foot technique because it's just so powerful. And the same thing, if you get a yes to that remedy for seasonal discomforts, you know, maybe, and you got a yes to do it to the soles of your feet, you could also make a little roll-on, which we have in Pinellas County here at Solterra, or I can send them to you, or you can go on Amazon.com or aromatools.com. And so that way you could just make up the remedy, roll it to your feet morning and night, several days in a row. So that's pretty cool. I want to back up one step though, and when I was talking about the drink, the cold and bug drink, got the yuckies, make sure that your essential oils that you're using has a supplement fact label from the FDA. If you do not have a supplement fact label, it's not safe to ingest. There could be additives to it, or they could be adulterated in some way that has, you know, different synthetics that you would not want to put inside your body. Most aromatherapy has a little bit of extra things added to it that would not be safe to ingest. So make sure you're using essential oil that is indeed able to be ingest. And even on the supplement fact label, it says for internal use, do one drop with 4 ounces of water, for instance, with the lemon. So that's really cool. Another thing that is super awesome, if you get a like really yucky bug that seems to be so foreign in nature that you don't know what it is, but you're not feeling well. And this is a cold balm, it's called. And it's On Guard or Protective Blend, Melaleuca, also known as tea tree oil in some circles, and oregano. And these, I have to say, I've done what you're gonna do is you put 5 drops of the Protective Blend, 5 drops of Melaleuca, and only 3 drops of oregano, and you put them in a gel cap. A veggie cap, and I don't have them here right now, they're at our house, but you put them in that little gel cap with a steady hand, a veggie cap, and you swallow it. You can do it 3 to 4 times a day. Again, I would definitely tell you to muscle test, even for that remedy. Maybe your body, you know, only wants 1 drop, or maybe it's a smaller weighing person where you're, you know, smaller people don't need as much, whereas your larger person might need a little bit more drops. I've worked with hundreds of people, and I have never seen people really muscle test past 5 drops of an oil. So your body's really smart. That's why I love your body, because it's, you know, the best teacher you've got if you actually listen to it. Another one that's really helpful is just old plain old peppermint. So if you've got a fever, if any of the children in your household or you're getting a fever, what is a fever? It is your body's natural response to go ahead and start to fight off some infection or fight off something that it took in internally or inhaled or however it got it inside. And so it starts creating heat. And so we don't want to take something that stops the fever. We might want to lessen the fever because it's like getting really high and you're nervous about your child. But you want to cool the person down. So what I suggest is taking about 5 to 10 drops of peppermint and putting it in a spray bottle with water. And then spraying your child, have them close their eyes and like cool them off, spray their back. You can put, what's his name again?
Tristan.
You can put, you know, a drop to their foot and it'll cool them down. And again, what's so awesome about peppermint is it's like, you know, so powerful that even when it goes to the foot, again, it goes systemic and helps that person to wherever the body's needing it. And next thing is earaches in summer, or excuse me, winter discomforts. A wonderful thing to put around the ear, never inside the ear, is basil for pain, as well as cypress, ginger, helichrysum, lavender. Those are all really awesome single oils. Another one that you could put around the ear is breeze.